Well, guys, we have a special guest. You guys remember Genesis Detailing? So, I'm going to do a video today for you guys because I haven't even driven this thing. And I think, honestly, there's something wrong because he told me, and if you guys haven't seen, let me walk you around his. Well, what year is this thing again?
2018
Ford F-150. He's done no leveling kit. You can see how it's still stink bugging over here in the back. And he doesn't tow too much. So as you guys know, he tows his little blue Weekend Warrior 24 footer.
31 according to the date.
Oh, of course. Okay, well, it's like 24 feet.
No, it's a 27 footer.
27, 26, something like that. Yeah. I'll show you. It's the blue one, you guys remember. But that's what he tows with this thing. And there's, actually, why didn't you even go with a leveling kit? Let's say
why
that.
Didn't I?
Yeah, why didn't you like want to get rid of the stink bug look?
Because this truck's not a diesel, right? I'm not gonna say that it can tow, but
it can tow. It says it tows like what, 12,000? 13,000 pounds.
So why would I want to why would I want to risk ruining any more than the one it can already tow by adding a leveling kit, making me squat? The whole point is think about it. When you put a tow, it levels you out. So if I level myself out already, this thing already can't tow, so if I level it, now I'm like the Cali lift.
Which he says this thing can't tow, guys, but I'm gonna have to disagree with
him. I'm not gonna say that it can tow, but it can't tow, but like it for sure can't tow as well as obviously your truck. I'm not gonna be stupid.
No, but so
My F-150 tows.
I've seen him tow, and this thing tows great. I mean, he does, you know, 65 up the grades. He's probably pulling with his trailer, I'd say maybe 7,000-8,000 pounds.
With
what do you think?
Razor?
With everything, with razor, fuel.
The trailer dries what, 5,500?
I think it says on there.
And the razor's another. So call it 8,000.
Call it 8. 000. Yeah, we'll call it with water. You know, holds 100, a little more than 100. I think 120 gallons some of water. So pretty much when he does tow with this thing, it does sit, you know, nice and level, and he does use the distribution bars on it. Now, he did put some rims and tires. Rims, he chose. What kind of rims are these right here?
Four-wheel parts, the new ones. I don't know. They're like the S-line.
Okay. And he went, this is his third set of tires in 3 days, I want to say. So tell us, and well, first of all, so as we know right now, there is no leveling kit on this thing. It's just all he did was rims and tires. Yep. The size, what size? We got 275, 55, 20. And that's a stock tire size?
Stock tire size.
Okay, so he didn't even go any bigger. And what's crazy is this thing, when he pulled up, these tires do look a lot bigger than what he had, you know, the pizza cutter tires that he had on this thing. This thing looks massive, but they're not. They're the exact same size. Now, here's why I'm making this video for you guys, because I have not driven it, and he's going to give you pretty much the honest opinion for you guys that want to keep the smooth ride, keep your truck. You know,
you buy a platinum to get a platinum, right?
Yeah, I mean, it's quiet. This thing's really
comfy,
quiet.
Super quiet. There's no road noise, obviously, with the factory tires. And the reason why I went with three different sets of tires is because, obviously, I wanted the looks. You have a nice wheel on there. You don't want to, you know, destroy that with the street tire. So the factory tires that they came with were street tires. So the time for new tires anyway. So we put an all-terrain one step above the street tire, which was not too aggressive. It looked good. But it just didn't look right.
What brand was that?
Those are the DynaPro AT2s.
Okay.
Hankooks. And
how did those drive?
Oh my, it was smooth. So those all terrains were very nice. They were quiet. They were smooth as hell. I didn't realize how smooth they were until I put these on.
So
not saying these are bad.
Yeah, and before he keeps going with this, guys, you know, when he pulled up, I was like, dude, something is wrong with your truck.
Funky.
Like, yeah, it was just because it just looked like another street tire. Like, you see, when you look at this Nitto.
Let me see if I can pull
it. Pull the photo. So, you see this Nitto. You see how it's got, you know, sidewall. You see how it's got nice, thick grip. Yeah, this tire, it looks aggressive, you know. And when he pulled up with those street tires, I'm like, dude, this thing just, it does not. Yeah, so look at this. I mean,
it has a lot of sidewall.
I don't know. Show the whole truck. Do the whole. Yeah, so that's the whole truck, yeah, with the trailer. So, I don't know. I was just like, yeah, no. You know, your truck, you do what you want, but then
I definitely didn't love it. I was disappointed when I picked up the truck, excited for the new wheels and tires, and
now,
I was
disappointed. Disappointed of what? The look?
The look, for sure. So,
okay. But smooth ride, that we know.
Yes, I drove home, and I was like, okay, this is nice. I like it, but then I know I look like crap, though.
Okay. In his opinion.
It looked bad.
In his opinion.
It looked bad. Okay. Even everyone, like the whole mechanics that looked at it, like, listen, it's a good wheel, but man, the tire needs to go. So. Yeah.
And two days later, he sent me. Yeah, he sent me this photo, which he asked me. I said, dude, I run the Nitto Ridge Grapplers. I've been running them for a while now. I'm very happy. You know, like you guys know, I did run the Nitto or the Toyo Mud Terrain. Good tire, very loud tire. You know, so I was like, yeah, I'm over it. Then I went with the Toyo, the RTs. Good tire.
Good.
Yeah, it was okay. Not
They're
too
flat.
Quiet.
They look flat.
They do. They look flat, but it did horrible in the desert. Yeah. It was a horrible tire. Like, and you just felt, I felt it right away. Then went with these Nitto Ridge Grapplers. I love them in the desert, love them on the street. Very quiet
the
to
best
me.
Looking tires.
Yeah, look wise. And to me, this tire is very quiet. To this guy over here, we'll go ahead. I'm going to let him explain to
what he coming from the Platinum, did. Like I said, we had a nice street tire, factory wheels. It looked great, rode great, smooth, quiet. I'm not used to these big trucks like you guys. I know everyone probably that watches the channel has a nice big diesel truck on like a 35 tire on
35. We got like
37
minimum. You gotta be at 37.
Maybe like a 12 inch. I don't know. You guys are all crazy, right? So this is a big step for me. But
didn't even go bigger with the tire size.
No,
too.
No,
it's stock
we,
tire
like
size.
Like I said, we're keeping factory. We like to stay stock.
Okay.
Judging from the factory tire, you hear a hum. That's for sure. I hear a hum. To Eddie, it's probably super quiet still. But there's nice.
I hear exhaust.
There's road
guys.
Noise. No, there's road noise. It's bumpy. Like, I feel the bumps now. I have a lot of rubber, and it absorbs everything. I feel it. Like, boom. And
this is why I'm making this video, guys. I'm doing it.
From a street guy.
Yeah, I'm doing an honest review.
It's a highway truck.
Yeah, I wanted him to talk about it because it's an honest review, and it's for people. There's people on my channel that like the F-150, so.
Oh, like, I love my truck, right? I've had it for 2.5 years now. I'm obsessed with it. That's why I don't have a new truck. And I've always wanted wheels and tires, but I never knew what setup to go with. And I didn't want to put something that makes it too aggressive, but also like without having to do a lift. You know, you don't want to trim. I wanted to stay as fast as possible while looking somewhat good. And obviously, I don't know about you guys, but I like the way this truck looks right now.
What do you guys think?
This is simply just wheels, tires, no lift, no level, no anything. So it's functional, it's reliable, and if it drives good. It's shiny too, huh?
Stop, I'm surprised. I've never seen this truck clean for a guy that owns a detailing.
Like I said, 40,000 miles on this thing already in 2 years. That's 20,000 miles a year.
Damn. Yeah, wow. For a guy that owns a detailing business, this thing is usually disgusting. Like, it's usually nasty.
That's a good thing.
So.
Back to the tire, though.
Back to, yeah, if so what would you recommend?
Toyos?
No, just how do you, I mean, I know if you put a Toyo MT on there, I know you would hate
so
life.
Remember I was looking at the Toyo AT3s that
yes,
came out?
Yes, yes.
Find me those. I was going to put those on there, yes. But I couldn't find them, and no one had them in stock from, like, Nationwide somehow. Welcome to COVID. But these tires, my honest review. Short-term review, they're not as bad as I thought they were. You definitely have to compromise a little bit of comfort for the way they look. I know I look great now compared to what it looked like before, so I'm happy with that. You know, I wanted that good look. I wanted the aggressive, but like medium in-betweener, and these are the perfect tires for that. So if you do have an F-150, you don't want to do any leveling or cutting, stay the same factory size, they look good. And you can tell by that wheel, I'm sticking out just a little bit because of that beefy sidewall.
Yeah,
and that's the perfect little.
There you go, guys. Give you a little side. Yeah, that's not bad. And
that's not bad.
I mean, you guys know me. I hate. Like, I can't. I don't know. I mean, again, it's whole personal, but I don't understand why these people bring, you know, your rims and tires out, you know, to here.
6 inches.
And what's the point of
to
having.
Ask what size wheel that is. So, factory is a 20x8.5. This is just a 20x9. So, half an inch made that big of a difference.
That difference. So, that's another thing. But. Real quick, like I'm saying, yeah, I'm not a fan of that look with the tire being all the way out here and having 40 inch rims and a 42 inch tire, like rubber band. Like, to me, for a whole truck purpose, is I want some meat on the tire. If I do need to take it off roading, yeah, functionality. If you want to take it off roading, you got meat, you know. Another thing is I don't want them sticking out because I don't want the whole side of my truck having tons of rock chips all over it. That's the thing. So that's why I chose my look, and I assume that's why he chose his look right here.
I went with the Ridge Grapplers because it's a nice hybrid. It's not too aggressive like you were saying with the Mud Terrains. It's not a street tire. These are the perfect tires for me.
Okay. And this is a 20x9?
20x9.
With a what? Plus 18?
That
offset?
I can't tell you. I have no idea.
So guys, this looks like, I'm just looking at it. This looks like probably a plus 22 offset. You know, for sure, obviously you can see, and usually you can tell by, you know, the lip also and how far it's in. So I would say probably plus 22, maybe. It's a plus for sure, higher end plus. Mine is a plus 18 offset. Mine sticks out a little more, but also I have a 37, yeah, you have a 13 and a half. Yeah, bigger and wider tire.
22 or 20?
No, I have a 20 inch rim.
Same thing.
Yeah, but I just did a 37, 13, 50, 20. So that's his opinion, guys.
One thing about the wheels is you can see how like this inner diameter is like an 18 almost. I do wish 4Wheel Parts made these wheels go all the way out. Fill in that gap. That's one complaint about these tires or the wheel.
He's talking about that right
gap in between. So
don't worry, guys.
Further away,
he's probably going to change these and put some methods or something on there. I'm sure these won't last very long. So. Well, let me know what you guys think. Comment down below. But now we got to go check the tri-tip. Oh, yeah. Shout out to Fern's Barbecue for helping me cook this thing. Woo! I think it's got to come out. I got to go. I got to take this thing out real quick. Stand by. But now we got to finish up old tractor here. Finish welding that stuff up. So I can get this thing out of my garage because I gotta pull some other stuff in here to get working on. But this monster has taken up pretty much almost half. And this thing, well, still cannot find the damn seals for the steering rack on this. Hopefully this week this thing will be done because I need this thing, guys. I need this forklift. Like I have to, when I rotate tires, I'm, you know, changing tires, picking stuff up. You know, I don't know how people can live without a forklift, man. I think everybody, if you need one thing, you should always have at least one forklift in the house. It's like mandatory. Or actually don't buy one, because what's going to happen is you're going to get spoiled like me. And then when your forklift is down and not working, well, it's going to suck and you're not going to be able to get nothing done because there is no steering box in there. Look at that. Empty. Nothing. And then after that, we're going to rewire, see all this crap. Get rid of that. Clean all this up, make it nice and shiny. Stay tuned for that. And for you guys asking me about the box, saying it does not work in the 2021, you're right. But we just got the new boxes in. So it was weird, guys. The one boxes that we had, which is this is the original, for some reason it did not work in the 2021 GM vehicles or BMWs. And some BMWs it did, some it didn't. It's weird. And this one, it's supposed to work in everything. BMW, Mercedes, Rolls-Royce, GM, the whole shebang. But I'm not going to say yes or no yet because I want to test it and make sure this thing actually works. And if it really works, well, then I'll let you guys know. And I will post it on my Instagram. Make sure you guys are following me on Instagram at Eddie's Life. And I'll be able to keep you updated. You'll see, you know, what's going on with it, if it does work, if it's not working. And stay tuned, we got another product coming out. I'm not going to say yet what's coming out until I physically have it, make it perfect. I don't want to sell anything, guys, that doesn't work. That's why I was kind of really pissed at, you know, I'm like, gosh, how does this thing not work in 2021s, you know? And it literally works in a 2020, but will not work in a 2021 Duramax called Denali. It's weird. I don't understand why. You know, I don't know what they changed that little thing to change for it to not work. So hopefully we got it working. So stay tuned for that. But that's all I got for you guys. Comment down below. Let me know what you think about Nick's new setup. I think it looks good. You know, I like it. I think the rims look good. I think the tires look good. He just says he's not really liking the ride. He says they're a little loud. Obviously, like I told him, I said, for me, honestly, they're not loud. But again, when you are 5-inch, you know, DPF back exhaust on the rammer, you know, it tends to draw out all, any of the, you know, I guess tire noise, if you want to call it. But comment down below. Let me know what you guys think about that and see. But that's all I got for you guys. So thank you guys for watching this video. If you like this video, don't forget to hit that thumbs up button. Don't forget to click subscribe. Peace.
Yeah.